first of all, I'm a very bad English speaker. So, but I'm a good French speaker. As we say in France, we found the answer in say, when you français je meurs, far away from French speaking, I will die. Okay? So I am I'm a Dennis developer, writer and teacher. And I work for a company in Paris, which is called SmileDCS, or Better System. And I wrote some book. And the last one is this one, the income marketing, means little genius in French. A quick story for history for Yocto. It's quite an old project, started as Open Embedded with OpenZorus. Because this route was not smart enough at this time, it's much better today. And it's based on recipes. The recipe is how to cross-compile links for a target And there is a tool named Bitmake, which is kind of Gmake, much better than Gmake, but it's quite the same thing, to run open embedded recipes. And it was inspired by a portage from Gentoo and written in Python. And the Yocto project itself started in 2010 by Intel with Open Embedded, including lots of the projects from including Open Embedded, Debate, Pocky Reference Distro, GDC, and a very good documentation, which was not the case before. For Yocto, there was no documentation. The documentation for Open Embedded was everywhere there was a freedom to belong to you. So, no, there is a very nice book with 400 pages and lots of books around the project. So, it's quite complicated to use, but you can find all the variables in the documentation. It's not like Android, because Android. It's quite complicated to modify and use, but to have no documentation. Except some books from before, but quite nothing from Google. So is an excerpt of documentation with Yocto layer. So when you get Yocto, you get these two layers, and you can add any layer you want, and you can add a layer for your own application or extensions. For example, we will talk about ZenUI, which needs a layer, a specific layer, because it's quite complicated if we compare with the official client key. So some principles based on recipes. You can extend recipes. We'll talk about it during the presentation. You can use classes. You have configuration files, input files. Everything should be in the meta in layer, actually, meta whatever. And there is a very few number of mainline targets. That was not the case for Open Embedded. So it was a real problem. And with Yocto, you have only two main targets, big and black, one PDC board, generic x86, and an edge router. I didn't know the edge router, but it's a and if you want to add a new platform, such as Raspberry Pi, you need to add a meta VSP, meta layer. So if you want to compile Yocto for the P3, for example, you get the Yocto distribution, actually it's Yocto, with Open Embedded, etc. You can get the meta Raspberry Pi layer. To create the big directory, you add the meta Raspberry Pi layer, you define the machine, and then you build a simple image, which is called Magic Micro, and you create the micro SD, and so you have your full menu on the board. It's quite simple. Now, if you want to use real time, it's much more complicated because actually there is an official support for 330 in Yocto, but it's quite difficult to use, and I don't know if it is really useful. using white people. So that the one scholar talks about juridics and real time atmosphere. So there are two ways. The pre-aperti project, which is a single kernel patch, very easy to install. And Xenomai, which is a co-kernel approach with the Cobalt. And it's a kernel patch, which is called IPy, and some libraries and tools, etc. Actually, for Xenomai, there is a user space part. And for pre-aperti, you can do the standard user space part. It's the main difference. With the new Xenomai 3, you can work on top of pre-aperti. It's called Mercury. But I think it's from the specific version from NEMS, which was called Xenomai Solo. And now it's called Mercury in the main name of Xenomai. But most of people use Cobalt because it's much more efficient. So pre-aperti is the official Linux RT patch. RTI was a fork for RT Linux 3 when it was 3. Now it's dead when it was 3. Okay. By Paolo Tegazza, Xenomai is the fork of RTI by Philippe Gérard, who is a French developer, very famous French developer in the RT ecosystem. So the co-kernel is more complex to use, but it is much more efficient. If you at least it's about 2 times more efficient. It could be more, depending on the configuration or the quality of the patch. But it's a bit difficult to use because the hardware support can be a bit tricky to set up. There is a specific kernel interface for the drivers, which is called RTDM, because it's a specific kernel. It looks like Linux drivers, but if you have a Linux driver, you have to import the Linux driver to RTDM. And its application design could be some difficult because of the migration program. Actually, on Xenomai, you have two domains, one for Linux and one for Xenomai for the real time. And if you call some system calls from the Xenomai, Linux system call from Xenomai, you will lose the real-time capabilities, so it's a real problem. And if you have a big program, it could be very tricky to develop. So, RT and big systems. Yocto and Vinroot are big systems. It's very easy to build RT image in Vinroot because it's included in Vinroot. Pre-aperti is a single kernel patch, so you have just have to configure your kernel. And to say the kernel patch is here with the configurator, graphical configurator. And Xenomai and RTE support has been available for a long time, so it's quite simple to install. For Yocto, there is a dedicated kernel recipe for the Linux Yocto kernel, which is for Linux Yocto RT, with a dedicated image, core image RT. With a depending on Linux Yocto RT, it's just this. There is only one dependency on the kernel plus adding RT test, which is a set of tools for testing real time. But if you check the recipe, the compatible machines are linked to Emu systems, which is not the good choice for real time. So you can say just for a test. For our testing and integration of the pre-aperti, but it's not really for using real time. From Xenomai, there is a support in Italy LDK from DEX, but it's quite old. And so, it's not very usable today. And it's dedicated to ELDK, which is a specific distribution from DEX instead of COPY. So in Yocto you have a very interesting functionality which is extending recipe. So you update the recipe which is a DB with a DB appen. And the most simple example is a splash screen. There was a before splash screen with open embedded logo. And in the new Mitapoki, there is the same recipe with a DDFN and a new logo, which is the Yocto logo. So it's quite simple to change files, to add files, to define new functions. For example, this recipe, extended recipe, activates the I2C bus on the Raspberry Pi because it's not activated by default. So we can use this system for PreEmpty. PreEmpty is very simple because you have just to patch a kernel. So we create a new layer, entire test name, and you add a recipe for the kernel with an extension of the recipe. So you have to define, of course, the path for the patch, empty patch. Configuration file, which is always a dev config file in the standard Linux Yocto kernel, and a DDFN with only lines such as this one, except the poppy because it's not dedicated to poppy. The PreEmpty kernel bunch is available from some boards, so you don't have to apply the patch, you don't have to get the commit for the active branch. For example, the big open branch, there is a branch for PreEmpty. But it's much more complicated for Xenomai because you have the two parts of Xenomai, so we have to develop a specific layer. This one is not really a specific layer, it's just an extension of the kernel. Just one word about Beta Raspberry Pi, that there is a Linux kernel, of course, in Beta Raspberry Pi, but it's not really compatible with the extension, so you have programs you want to apply fragments or extension. So I wrote a new recipe for so Linux Raspberry Pi kernel, but it works only for P3, and the standard kernel works for all the type of Raspberry Pi. So the Xenomai is difficult as you have to patch the kernel with a specific script, which is called Prepar kernel. It's a patch, but it's at CDX between 5, so you have to teach a procedure for the device. And you need to install the non-space file. It's based on autoconf, but you have to do that. There was a GitHub Xenomai layer, some seed on GitHub, that was really updated, out of date. So I got the current GitHub Xenomai. I create a new Linux Xenomai that works actually only for the Raspberry Pi 3. And the user space recipe, which is autocomp based, so it's quite simple. The most difficult part is to add a specific function to patch the kernel, to run the prepar kernel before configuring the kernel. It's only for cobalt, of course. And this function is executed before configuring the kernel with the add task. So the best way is to show you the code because on slide is not really that simple. Okay. So you know you have the prepar kernel function. So you run the standard procedure for installing the Xenomai, patching the kernel. You call prepar kernel. And you say to Yocto, to be paid, then you will execute prepar kernel after the boot patch, after patching the kernel, and before configuring the kernel. So it's quite simple when you have the function. And the difficult part in Xenomai is to get the right patch because if you have a specific board with a specific kernel for a BSP, you need to get the right patch to run with Xenomai. So you have to adapt the patch. So the recipe is not the most difficult part of the work. The most difficult part is to get the IPy core patch working. or you can create a dedicated IMAT recipe. So you need to use a pressure provider or a command from Yocto. So you say pressure provider /kernel/linux/enumal. The /kernel recipe is the name of the current kernel, the default kernel. So you say to force the default kernel to the Xenomai kernel. And then you have to install, of course, the user space part, which is the Xenomai recipe. This is quite simple, it's just user space store. I can show you the recipe, but recipe, Xenomai. Xenomai. So you just have to inherit from AutoTools and the Gateway config and some options. You have to import for the PI recipe. For Raspberry Pi, you have to enable the ACP and for the cobalt, but I think it is the default. And you can build a specific image. So you say the kernel is the Xenomai kernel. Just one thing about the P3. The P3 Pi3. The Pi3 is quite specific because the default UART is used by the Bluetooth. So you have to say I use a fake UART, it's a binding of UART, that is not an official UART type and previous Pi. But it doesn't work with Xenomai. I don't know why. Should be a problem with real time. So you have to force the standard UART. You don't have the right to Bluetooth, but it's not important for our real time. So you have to force the default UART, hardware UART, to use the Xenomai. And to get the console. If you use a graphic screen, graphical screen is okay. But I don't use graphical screen most of the time, so I like my console. Okay. There are some work to do because I didn't test on a recent version of Yocto. We not solicited to do and to test on new boards. But most of time is done by end users. So you can get the recipe from the Xenomai. You can just have to change the batch, just to modify your recipe to match your kernel definition. And should work. I have some customer using Intel with Raspberry Pi. I didn't know that. Let us say, some time ago, I used the one layer for Intel. So it's quite simple once you have these recipes. I can show you a simple demo. Okay? So, you have to run this. type of poster in a real situation. And if I change for 330, I just have to change the flash, the SD card.
Thank you for that.